Greetings. If you are interested to know what the prophets revealed, I encourage you to watch this whole video. In part 3, I focused on the promise of God the Redeemer being fulfilled. I've used a verse from Job twice, but have not addressed all of it. Job 19:25, "As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives." You have seen this part already if you've watched parts 2 and 3. Now carefully consider what the rest of this verse says. "And at the last, he will take his stand on the earth." God will stand on the earth. Now there will be a temptation here to focus on the word last, and that must come to the mind of Muslims because they have an issue. This series is about the message of the prophets, and what they said refutes Islam's message. Islam claims God cannot enter his creation. The prophets, however, said that God would come to his creation. The first verse has already been shared with you. "And at the last, he will take his stand on the earth." But let's look even in Genesis. After Adam and Eve had sinned, something very interesting happened. Genesis 3:8, "And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden." God walked in the Garden of Eden. This is the Lord God, Yahweh, Elohim. And God's footsteps made sounds in physical space-time. "And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking." Yahweh Elohim has feet. Yahweh Elohim has already entered his creation, scant days or weeks or years after creation. So the argument God cannot enter his creation is DOA, dead on assertion. Prophet Moses records that God has already entered his creation physically. But where else have the prophets recorded that God has already entered his creation? Genesis 18:1, "Now the Lord, Yahweh, appeared to him by the oaks of Mamre, while he was sitting at the tent door in the heat of the day. When he lifted up his eyes and looked, behold, three men were standing opposite him. And when he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them, and bowed himself to the earth." Now, verse 1 just said Yahweh appeared to Abraham. So one of these three quote-unquote men was Yahweh in physical human form, and said, "My Lord, if now I have found favor in your sight, please do not pass your servant by." Now this word, Lord, is from the Hebrew Adonai, and not Yahweh. The fact this is God is established in verse 1. God in physical appearance like a man. "Please let a little water be brought and wash your feet and rest yourselves under the tree." God had feet that Abraham offered water to wash. "And I will bring a piece of bread that you may refresh yourselves. After that you may go on, since you have visited your servant." And they said, "So do as you have said." Abraham brought God bread to eat, again demonstrating God exhibited a physical presence in his creation. So Abraham hurried into the tent to Sarah and said, "Quickly, prepare 3 measures of fine flour, knead it, and make bread cakes." Abraham also ran to the herd and took a tender and choice calf, alive, and gave it to the servant, and he hurried to prepare it. He took curds and milk, and the calf which he had prepared, and placed it before them, and he was standing by them under the tree as they ate. Realize how long God was physically with Abraham. Enough time to kill and prepare, meaning cook, the calf. No microwaves, no McAbdullahs nearby. This was hours where God chilled with Abraham, waiting on the Barbie, physically in his creation. So Prophet Moses records that Adam and Abraham both physically interacted with Yahweh God. But what did the prophets say about the future? After all, a major task for prophets is to reveal the future, to prophesy. Prophet Isaiah mentions someone who will be called Mighty God. Isaiah 9:6, "For a child will be born for us, a son will be given to us, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace." This child, this son who will be born for us and given to us, will be called Mighty God. A child being born is a physical, real-world event. Prophet Isaiah also mentions someone who will be called God with us. Isaiah 7:14, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel." The interesting thing is Emmanuel means God with us. And there again, the prophets have foretold God physically entering his creation. This time as a son, a boy born of a virgin. Where else do the prophets mention God in the earth? Past, present, or future? When Moses saw the burning bush, God was physically present. Exodus 3:2, "And the angel of the Lord Yahweh appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed." So Moses said, "I must turn aside now and see this marvelous sight, why the bush is not burned up." When the Lord Yahweh saw that he turned aside to see, God called to him out of the bush. That means God was in the bush. God called to him out of the bush, "Moses, Moses." And he, Moses, said, "Here I am." God spoke from in the burning bush. That means God was there. God entered his creation to speak directly to Moses. Prophet Zechariah revealed God possesses what can only be described as a physicality. Zechariah 12:10, "Then I will pour out a spirit of grace and prayer on the family of David and on the people of Jerusalem. They will look on me whom they have pierced, and mourn for him as for an only son. They will grieve bitterly for him as for a firstborn son who has died." God revealed that he would be pierced by the inhabitants of Jerusalem. That implies a physical form which could be pierced, harmed. Keep this in mind and ponder how and when those in Jerusalem could pierce God. So there are multiple examples where God has already entered his creation, and there are prophecies of God interacting inside creation. God would be pierced by the inhabitants of Jerusalem, Israel, earth. I know the damned American regime is ignorant that Jerusalem is in Israel, but they are damned by their choices and the hardness of their hearts. Since there is copious evidence that God can enter his creation, it is preposterous to claim an all-powerful God cannot enter his creation. And yet there is a misguided and false religion that makes just such an illogical claim. That an all-powerful God cannot do something completely logical and obvious. I am not speaking of ill-formed logical paradoxes, such as Can Allah make a rock too big for Allah to move? It is enough to know the prophets refute their claim and prove God can enter and has entered His creation. There is one other topic, one other set of interlocking predictions so powerful they deserve their own video. And I will get to that in part 5. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth of the message of the prophets, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.